आई नो राहुल सर विल रिस्पॉन्ड वेरी क्विकली. इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट ही विल बी, इफ यू टेल ही विल नॉट लिसन टू यू. वंस आई यू कॉल व्हाट ही टोल्ड, आई कांट डू दैट.
नो सर.
देन
सर इट्स नॉट रिंगिंग सर.
इट्स नॉट रिंगिंग.
यस सर. आई थिंक सर राहुल सर मोबाइल डाटा इज ऑफ सर ऑन दैट टाइम.
ऑन दैट टाइम व्हाट
सर? राहुल सर मोबाइल डाटा इज ऑफ सर. नेट सर इज नॉट रिंगिंग सर.
यू कैन कॉल ऑन हिज नंबर नो डायरेक्टली. It means you are not having interest only. You don't want to put the thing in voice.
Sir, I don't have SIM card, sir. What interest?
Achha. So all the time his mobile is off, data is off, right? All the time.
No.
And home you are not having anybody else also mobile. Huh? What man Priyanshu? If you want to do, you can do by anything, right? Now what I should do? I'll clear your doubts.
No, sir.
You send me on WhatsApp, right?
Yes, sir. I send you one question, sir. Sir, on Sunday, sir, you will be here.
I'm pasting over here. All of you children, tell me this one. What is the word? What is the answer for this? What's, can you see this?
No, sir.
1 minute. Why it's not testing over here? All of you on the camera, children, now. See, this is the question sent by Priyanshu. Okay, who can solve this question? Just tell me, children. Anyone who can solve this question? See, the question is like this only, Priyanshu, right?
Yes, sir.
The question is like, why it's not working here? Wait till close and on this again. Stop.
Sir, we can do other things, sir.
Sir, you stop.
Yeah.
Sir, what's your doubts around WhatsApp, sir? On next day. Bye.
Achha. Wait. Stop share. Stop coming or not. Wait.
Sir, we will do doubt sessions on next day.
Next day? No. We'll finish your doubt first. Okay. Anyone, children, having doubt in any subject or any topic, you are having doubts? 9 to the power n into 3 to the power 2 into 3 to the power minus n by 2 to the power minus 2, minus 27 to the power n. You have done this one, Priyanshu, now.
What, sir?
You have done this question you have done?
No, sir. I did not get the answer, sir.
Where you got this question?
Sir, in workbook, sir.
So see, we have to prove that m minus n is equal to 1. So question is like n to the... You should just simplify this, okay? So how we can do over here?
Sir, is it 27 power n?
Yeah, 27 to the power n, yes.
Okay, sir.
Hmm. So what we can do for this? See, 9 to the power n means 3 to the power 2 and whole to the power n, right? Again into 3 to the power 2. Again, what we can write into 3 to the power, this minus n by 2 into minus 2. So this 2 and 2 will get cancelled, minus will get cancelled, minus minus plus, minus 3 to the power 3 to the power n, divided by 3 to the power 3m into 2 to the power 3 is equals to 1 by this one, 27, right? So 3 to the power 3. Can you write like this? So what we can write now on the numerator side, 3 to the power 2m plus 2, again plus n, minus 3 to the power 3n, whole divided by 3 to the power 3m into 2 to the power 3 is equals to 1 by 3 to the power 3. Correct? Correct, no? So can we write this 3 to the power 3m? Can we write like this 3 to the power 3m is equal to 3 to the power 3 into 3 to the power m? Can we write like this? No, we can't write like this. Because 3 to the power 3m can be written only 3 to the power 3.
3 to the power 3 bracket m.
Correct. So it's like this, right? So we can't cancel this one also. Now what we can do? This 3 to the power 3 we can multiply in the numerator side if you want, correct? Why it's going up and down today? Mommy. Hey. Why this is happening?
Sir, 3 to the power 3n minus 3 power n. We can cancel that, right?
This one, we can't cancel this one. See.
No, sir. I mean like 3 to the power 3n, right? After you add 2n plus n, then it will be 3n.
Yes,
cancel
yes.
Cancel that, right?
Yeah, yeah. You are saying this one, right? 3 to the power 3n.
Yeah.
Plus 2. Minus 3 to the power 3n.
Yes.
Divide by 3 to the power 3m into 2 to the power 3. 1 by 3 to the power 3. After this, what to do?
Sir, we can remove 2n, then we can't cancel that. We can write 3 square then, right?
Wait, what I can write? Hey, why it's happening automatically? One minute. What this is happening? Wait for one minute, children. So we are doing doubt session, right? So 3 to the power 3n plus 2, it means what? This is 3 to the power 3n into 3 to the power 2. It's like this, no?
Yes, sir.
And whole divided by 3 to the power 3m into 2 to the power 3. See, one more thing you can... what happened, Hania?
Can't we cancel 3 power 3 and like...
this one you are saying?
Yeah. No. Minus 3 to...
this one?
Yeah.
No, you can't. This is a multiplication. How you can cancel this? 2 into 3 minus 2 is there, 2 will get cancel. Can you cancel like this? Tell me. So like this, you should think. So here is equal to 2 by 3 to the power 3. We can write like this. This 2 to the power 3 went up. Can we write like this or not? See, this 2 to the power 3.
Yes, sir.
This 2 to the power 3, I sent up here. But it came here 2 to the power 3, 3 to the power 3. It's clear. Now what I can do is 3 to the power 3 and common you can take from numerator side. It will come 3 to the power 2 minus 1. Divide by 3 to the power 3m. Is equals to 2 to the power 3. 2 to the power 3 is 2 into 2 into 2 divided by 3 into 3 into 3. It's like this only, no? Correct? Now 3 to the power 2 is what? 9. 9 minus 1 is what? 8. This whole thing will get cancelled or not? Understood what I'm saying? Is it clear or not? 3 to the power 2 minus 1 is nothing but 3 to the power 2 is what? 9. 9 minus 1, that is 8. And this is also 8. Can we cancel like this?
Yes, sir, but I didn't understand how we got 3 square minus 1.
See, 3 to the power n, 3n we have taken common. Sarithvik.
Sir. Yes, sir, but how will we get this 3 square?
The spending part will be 3 square only now.
Okay, sir.
So there are two parts. First part is this one and second part is this one. So from first part and second part, we have taken this common from both. So this is the common one. So what is pending part? 3 square is the pending one. And minus here, nothing is pending. So 1. It's clear now?
Yes, sir.
Hania, is it clear to you?
Good evening, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good evening.
So that below in the denominator is written 3m or n?
M.
See, so then how could you cancel 3n and m?
Where we have cancelled? We have not cancelled anything now.
No, sir. Then how did you get 3 into 3? Okay, m value is given. Huh?
See, we have to prove m minus n is equal to 1. Like this, we should prove from this.
Okay. We got it, sir.
So 3 to the power 3n into 3 to the power 3. Divide by 3 to the power 3m is equals to 1. Now what we can write here, 3 to the power 3n plus 3 minus 3m is equals to 3 to the power 0. Okay. So 3 to the power 3 you can take common if you want. So n plus 1 minus, we can't take common from here. So simply no need to write now. Base are same. This part is also same only. 3n plus 3 minus 3m is equals to 0. So 3m minus 3n is equals to 3. So 3 you take common. M minus n is equals to 1.
So minus 3.
Minus 3. No, this I'm sending outside. This I'm sending this side. This I'm sending this side. So 3 will be this side only now. Not getting, Hania. What I've done.
I didn't get you.
See, what I've done here is this 3n and this 3n I'm sending to the other side. So I change the sign here. See, this become 3m and this become 3n. Understood? This both sign I've changed or not? See?
Yes, sir.
So this is the same place. This one is there, no? The other one. That is at the same place. See, plus 3 is at the same place only, right? I'm setting two things from the other side. Got it? Still not getting.
Yes, sir.
Not getting now?
Got it, sir.
Okay. So this got proved. Priyanshu, it's clear to you or not?
Yes, sir.
It's very difficult. No, it looks lengthy, but it's easy only. See? We have to keep on doing. We have proved right now.
Okay.
Any other sums you are having?
No, sir.
Okay. Now we are doing a few extra sums on which one? Which sum you are doing? This one, quadrilateral, no?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Suppose
sir, we have to start quadrilateral.
Actually, in yesterday class one, long back, see, before IMO, your exam fitting, we have started, no?
Yes, sir. Before IMO, before that thing, we have started a little bit.
And last class, we have done around 5-6 sums we have done in last class. So all the sums were proving sums. So few questions I given homework to the children.
So one question.
Only one question I given.
No, sir. I'm asking a question. Last week, we didn't have a math exam, right? Math test?
Yeah. Exactly.
Okay, sir.
So this time we'll have. So now quadrilaterals. Nihar, only one exercise is there in quadrilaterals, right? See your NCERT textbook.
Sir, two are there.
8.1, 8.2.
Yes, sir.
One is optional or that also is there?
No, sir. 8.2 is compulsory.
Acha. So shall we do all those sums only today? 8.1 we have done last time. 8.2 shall we do today?
Yes, sir.
So we'll just do 8.2 if you want. 1 minute. Let me check for exercise 8.2 NCERT.
Sir, 8.2 has 7 questions.
Yeah, this is awkward. It's not coming properly only. A class 9, chapter 8, right? The first question we have not done still. Last class we are doing, I think 8.2 we are doing last class, no?
Sir, 8.1, sir.
We are doing 8.1.
Yes,
what is the, sir. What is the first question in 8.1? Tell me. 8.1,
sir,
what is
like the ratio of sir 3 is 2, 4 is 2, and we have to find.
This was very easy, right?
Yes.
So second question also we have done, rectangle one. Fourth one also we have done. Till sixth we have done, right? Till sixth, did you remember?
Yes.
Sixth question we have done. In first exercise, how many exercises there in first chapter?
Sir, in quadrilateral, sir. Sir, two exercises there, sir.
Okay. So, first part we have done last time. And second exercise we are going to start now, okay?
In first exercise, many more questions there, sir. 7 to 8, sir.
You have not did anything? Last time I told you to do, not a single question you have done.
Yes, sir, you have told to do only 2 to 3 questions.
Total, how many questions are there?
Sir, 13.
13 are there. Till where you have finished? What? How many questions you have done? Tell me.
Sir, I have done, sir, first exercise.
Completely?
Yes.
Okay, what we do now, no? We'll do 10th sum, okay? 10th sum we do right now. Okay, Nihar, you just try once again. Till the sixth one we have done in last class, okay? Nihar?
Yes, sir.
We have done till sixth sum, and I told 4 or 5 questions you do from your side. That's why children might have done or not, I don't know. So I'm just doing from 10th question of first exercise only. See the question over here. Can you see the question? Yes. ABCD is a parallelogram. And AP and CQ are perpendiculars from vertices A and C on diagonal BD. Figure is given down. Check. Figure is given over here. So prove that, show that this is very easy question, right?
Yes. So
everyone can solve this question.
So we can do it by AAS.
Yes, sir.
AAS you can do, right?
Yes, sir.
So who cannot do this question? Tell me, all of you. Who cannot do this? Anyone who is not able to do this question, raise your hand so that I can solve over here. And who is not turning the camera, just move out of the meeting. It's not required.
Sir, I have net issues that I'm not able to on my camera.
Satvik?
Yes.
You are also having the same issue?
No, sir.
Okay, now see here. APB. APB, this triangle. And CQD, this triangle. How to become, this is 90 degrees given. This is also 90 degree. Again, one angle happened. Next, what is, how you can say AAS? Tell me, Nihar. How you can say this is AAS triangle? APB, I'm trying.
Angle APB is equal to angle CDP, alternate interior angles.
Angle ADP.
APB.
APB, huh? Is equal to
angle CDB, angle CDQ, because alternate interior angles.
CQD.
This one, right?
Yes, yeah, sir.
These two angles. Okay.
And AP is equal to CD. Opposite sides of parallelogram.
AP or CD?
AB equals to CD.
That DB is common, right?
DB, you can't say no, because this is coming in this triangle, right? See, this APB.
Sir, or we can say PQ is common. We can prove it by AAS or AS.
1 minute. I'm drawing both the triangles over here.
Sir, WhatsApp.
Okay, you have WhatsApp me. Fine. All right. Okay, honey, we do, after finishing this one, we do that, okay?
Sir, one doubt.
Say.
What are the cases where CPCT and CPCTC, like, I don't understand, are both the same or...
Both are same only. No changes. Okay,
sir. Yes, sir, okay, both sir. Are same, that eventually that E got removed.
Yes, sir, that was my doubt, okay.
CPCTC, not E. Congruent. Not equal, you can say congruent. So here APB, the CQD. So here what we can say, these both are 90 degree over here. Then what is there? AB is equals to CD. Same side of a parallelogram, right? Means opposite sides of a parallelogram, you can say. Next, angle you got, then angle D is equals to angle B. This is what we can say. So angle APB is equals to angle CQD. Again, angle B is equals to angle D. So by here only you got proof. No, by A is also there, right?
A
is not, A is not there, right? One
ASA and AAS, you can prove it by both.
Yeah. So AB is equals to CD, and you can write this is S. So by AAS congruency, triangle APB is congruent to triangle CQD. Now AP is equal to CQ, we can write easily. AP is equals to CQ. What you should write in bracket CP, CT by CP, CT. This all you can write, or CP, CT, C also you can write. Priyanshu. If I tell, then you on your camera, you are also offing again and again.
Yes. No.
Yes, sir. No, sir.
Sir, I warned, sir.
Okay, this is clear to everyone now. 10th question is clear. Now see the 11th one. You are having the textbook with you. Can you see that? There are 6 questions in this. 11th, there are 6 questions. Can you see that? 6 questions are there in question number 11th. See, this is the question. In triangle ABC, read all of you children, just try to understand this, what they are saying in the question. In triangle ABC and DEF, AB is equal to DE and AB is parallel to DE also. BC is equals to EF and BC is parallel to EF. Vertices ABC are joined to vertices DEF respectively. So you have to prove that quadrilateral ABED is a parallelogram. ABED is a parallelogram. So first, what we should do? Nihar, you can do this question.
Yes, sir. Sir, it's already given that it's a parallelogram. Like in a parallelogram, if one pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel, then it's a parallelogram. So ABED is a parallelogram. Same way, we can do it for BEFC. And then AD is, okay. Oh, yes, sir. So third one, I have to look, sir. 1 minute.
A, B, C, D. You can use like parallelogram. A, B, C, D is given, no? We have to prove that A, B, E, D is a parallelogram. So first you draw A, B, E, D. A, B, E, and D. So it's given that A, B is equal to D, E. A, B is equals to D, they have given the question. And A, B is parallel to D also. This is parallel to this. Next, B, C is equals to B, C. This one they have given. BC is equals to.
Yes, sir. I got it for the third one, sir.
EF. Huh?
Sir, I got the third one.
Hmm.
Sir, in that AD is a parallel. And BE is parallel to CF. So therefore, AD is parallel to CF.
No, from starting, we should say. Now you tell me from starting. Here they are asking quadrilateral ABED is a parallelogram. How do you prove ABED is a parallelogram?
So it's given all the things.
No, here they have given AB is parallel to DE.
Yes, and AB is equal to DE. So it's given.
Only one side they have given, no?
Yes, sir. It's a theorem, no? If one pair of opposite in a quadrilateral, if one pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel, then it's a parallelogram.
Only one pair is equal, then it's a parallelogram.
Pair are equal. Equal and opposite.
Yes. Now, second one, BEFC. BEF.
Okay. Sir, they have given all the information.
Here also it's given, right? So, this BE is parallel to EF, right? And this both are equal also. Again, the same thing. If one pair of these sides of a parallelogram are equal and parallel, then it's a parallelogram. Okay? You can write, children. See, you should write a statement that if a pair of sides are equal and parallel, equal.
Sir, if a pair of opposite sides.
Opposite sides. Are equal and parallel. You can write sides also because this parallel will not be happen. No. Pair of sides are equal and parallel. So, it's a parallelogram. Well, this here you should must remember this should be equal as well as parallel. Okay. If only one pair you find in any parallelogram, means any quadrilateral, then it's what? It's a parallelogram. Is it clear, children? It's clear to everyone.
Yes.
Satvik, I'm going to remove right now. Okay, to you. Satvik, what do you want? You want to you to call to that one? And then you should come back here. You want to like that only?
What, sir?
Why you're offing camera again and again?
Sir, before I went to bring my textbook, sir.
Now you want to bring your textbook?
No, sir, before.
Then BEC, this also happened. Now next third one is AD is parallel to CF. AD is parallel to CF. This is parallel to this. Means you can see this diagram. This AD is parallel to CF, they are saying. So you have to prove that AD is equals to CF. AD is equals to CF.
No, sir. Sir, they ask to prove AD is parallel to CF and AD is equal to CF. They ask.
Acha. So it's, if it is a parallelogram, then we can say that, right? So first we have to put parallelogram, right? How this is a parallelogram? How to prove this is a parallelogram? ACFD is a parallelogram. How? You proved already, Nihar.
Yes, sir. Sir, it's given, sir, for the first, from the first statement, we can, from the first thing which we proved that quadrilateral ABED is a parallelogram, from that we conclude that AD is parallel to BE. And in that, from the second thing which we proved, quadrilateral BEFC is a parallelogram, BE is parallel to CF. So therefore, AD is parallel to CF. Same way we can prove it with sides. AD is equal to BE, BE is equal to CF, AD is equal to ACF.
BEFC. The children are not necessary. See, once again, I'm just telling you once again what Nihar is telling, that you from first can triangle. Plus there, what happened?
Can I rejoin?
Yeah, fine. All right. So see what is happening here. From the first part, from the first one, we got to know that AD is parallel to BE. It's clear. From the second one line, we got that BE is parallel to CF. It's clear. So these all the three lines are parallel to each other. It means that AD is parallel to CF, right? AD is parallel to CF. From, this is your first, from first and second proof. From first and second part, right? Is it clear? And from ABC, AD is parallel to CF, as well as, and AD is equals to also CF. You can write in the same way. This is also same thing. Now quadrilateral ACFD is a parallelogram. ACFD. This is also same thing now. The same thing. If this third one got proved, the fourth one also got proved. The same. Why? Because theorem is only like that. If a pair of opposite sides are equal, same, it is fourth is also similar. Fourth is also similar like this only. See, this is green color. I'm writing here green color. This also writing green color. Same reason. Okay. Green color means what? Same reason you can write. Same reason. Next one is AC is equal to DF. Now if AB, if this is a parallelogram, how, this is obviously, this is a parallelogram, AC is equal to DF, right? So fifth one is, we know that ACFD is parallelogram. Okay. We know that ACFD is what? Parallelogram. So AC is equals to DF. We can write, if FCD is a parallelogram, because opposite sides are equal and parallel, because opposite sides of parallelogram are equal and parallel. Fifth part is clear. Now sixth one is ABC is similar to DEF. You should prove, it's not similar, congruent to DEF. So ABC, this triangle is similar to DEF, you should prove. So first, this line is parallel to this line. This line is parallel to this line. So how to prove this one? Congruent part, how to prove? By which similarity, by which congruency we can prove this? ABC is congruent to DEF. Which congruency we can prove?
SS.
See, Yeah, this side is equal to this side. AB is equals to DE. AC is equals to DF. And BC is equals to EF. By SSS congruency, we can prove ABC is congruent to DEF. The sixth one, by SSS congruency. So anyone who is having doubt in all the five parts, anyone who is having doubt, just raise your hand. Just try to explain once again if you are having doubt.
No doubt.
Sai Ritvik?
No doubt, sir.
No doubt. So this is the 11th. This was the 11th question. One, two question we do from other book. Okay. Wait for 1 minute. I'll just tell you the questions. It's hanging. The system is only hanging over here. 1 minute. So it's coming like, you know, it's taking a bit time. Wait. Wait for 1 minute, children. It's downloading right now. This question looks like weird, but what happened?
Sir, we can't see the question.
Sorry. Oh, yeah. 1 minute. Okay, I'm just drawing here only. Let it be download only. I'm just drawing the question once. Extra questions only. I'm just drawing this question. Leave this part right now. I'm just doing some other question. This is a question they have given over here in the textbook. Okay. So this is your parallelogram. This name is A, B, C, D. And this is 70 degree. This is your, again, what is given the question? Wait. They have given this a parallelogram. You have to, angle A is equal to 70 degree they have given over here. You should find B, C, D. This is very easy, no?
Yes, sir.
You can find angle B, angle C, angle D. Correct?
Angle is 110 degrees. Angle C is 70.
110, 70, and this is also 110. You understood, everyone, why it's so?
Yes, sir. Opposite sides, sir.
This is adjacent side. Adjacent sides are 180 degree. Sorry, adjacent angles. Adjacent angles are equal to adjacent angles is equals to 180 degree. So, 110 plus 170, so angle A plus angle B should be equal to what? 180. So you can write here angle A is 70 degree. 70 plus angle B is equals to 180. So angle B is equals to what? 110. If this become 110, this now is become very easy, right? So opposite angles are equal. So now it's clear, right? This both are what? Opposite angles are
equal and parallel.
Angles are equal. That's it. So next question.
Sir, can we have quiz?
On which you will have, which chapter you want quiz?
Sir, any chapter, sir, we are getting bored, sir, by
doing. See, by proving sums, you may get bored. But by this one, no, this kind of question, while finding the things, that will become easier, you know. Okay, tell me this quiz only, fast. Priyanshu, this one more question is coming on the screen. Tell me the answer fast, okay? This is again parallelogram. A, B, C, D. Okay. So, A, B, C, D is a parallelogram. Side DC is produced to E. DC is produced to E. DC is produced to E. And angle BC is equal to 105. BC is equal to, this is angle is 105 degrees. It's given. You should find angle A, angle B, angle C.
Angle C is 75 degrees. 105. 180 minus 105.
So this is very easy questions. These all are very easy, right, Priyanshu? It's easy now.
Yes, sir, 75 angle C, sir. Then, sir, A is also equal to 75.
75, B equals
up
105 and A equals 105.
So these are lanju panju sums. Chotu motu. Nihar, what are these sums?
So what?
What kind of these sums are? It's easy, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I'll just give harder sums now. Page number, this is 133, I think. Wait for 1 minute. But he's solved on the book only. That is the main thing here. What I should do? In this figure. Okay, see this figure now. This is this question you check. Question number 5th. In the given figure, ABCD is rhombus. In which angle?
The degree properly, sir. Like the diagram.
This, here you can see diagram you leave off. Here you only see. Only 1 degree is given. This is A, B, C and D. Okay. So angle A is given 72 degree. And CBD. C. BD means your this angle is given X. So find the value of X. Can you find the value of X now?
Sir, 54.
Sir, 1 minute.
Sir, 180 minus 70 divided by 2.
Okay. So these two angles are equal, right? These two sides are equal. So these two angles are also equal, correct? So if this is 72, so this is also 72 only. So 72 plus X should be equal to 180 degree. 72 plus 2X is equals to 180. So 2X is equals to what do we get?
Sir, 4.
108, no?
Oh, yes.
So X is equal to 108
divided by 2.
Sir, 54.
You're getting how it's coming? Sai Ritvik? Pulastya, it's clear?
Yes, sir. It's clear.
Pulastya?
Yes, it's clear.
Okay. Next sum. It's not that clear over here. 1 minute. See, another question is question number 13th. All of you check. See, this is the question. And figure of this, I'm just drawing right now.
Sir, we can see question half only. Like, sir, half is cut.
The down one is hint. Okay, Priyanshu, don't see the down one.
Okay, okay.
Only see two lines. DEC is an equilateral triangle in a square ABCD. Okay. DEC is equal to triangle in a square ABCD.
Sir, we can't see, sir. Sir, we can't hear your voice, sir. I think server disconnected.
Sir, answer is 75.
Sir, the answer is 75.
Hi, what children?
Answer is
75. All of you got anyone who is not getting the answer for this? Anyone who is not getting the answer for this? 75. Pulastya, you got the answer.
Sir, some of the question is cut out.
This is hint actually. Sairitvik, this is hint. You should not see this one. This part okay. Is not. This is
it up till the X part?
Yeah, till here only. Yes.
Oh, okay, sir.
It's 75 degree you also got, Sairitvik?
Yeah, sir.
Anyone who is not getting 70 degree, 75 degree over here? Pulastya? You are getting right, Sairitvik. Then nobody is here in the meeting.
I think we're 75.
So next question is, this was bit okay. Then Hania, any question you are having doubt?
Not now. That is that. Alas.
Achha, okay. Priyanshu, you want quiz now?
No, sir, we can do this.
Okay, one question you do, question number 7th one. Tell me the answer for this. In the adjoining figure, ABCD is a rhombus. Can you find children? AOB over here. OAB. This angle you can find. Shall I draw it once again? You are understanding this or not? Shall I draw once again?
Sir, we'll do it, sir. 1 minute.
Uh-huh. This is maximum 1 minute question. It's not
36 and 50. So 36 and 54.
Only OAB they are asking. Only OAB.
Oh, okay. Then that's 36.
36.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, is it 70?
Which one? OAB 70 you are saying, Priyanshu?
No, sir.
36.
See, first of all, this is 2x is given in the question and this is 3x. If this is a rhombus, this always cuts as 90 degree, okay? This diagonals bisect each other at 90 degree, right, Pulastya? So in rhombus, you should remember that diagonals bisect each other. Diagonals bisect each other at 90 degree. So what we can write here? In triangle OAB, triangle OAB. In triangle OAB, 2x plus 3x plus 90 degree is equals to what? 180 degree.
Yes, so now I got the 36.
5x is equal to 90, x is equal to 18. So here they are asking OAB. The angle OAB is nothing but find the angles of OAB, all angles. Okay, fine. Angle OAB is nothing. All the angles you can tell means this is very easy, right? 36. 54
and 90 degree. Right? Yes, sir. So, sir, are we done with
today's class? What, Nihar? Have sir, you?
Sir, are we done with today's class?
What, you are getting sleepy? Nihar?
No, sir, nothing like that. I was just asking, time is up now.
Yeah, yeah. See, first exercise in the NCERT part, children, all of you do. First exercise is there, no? There are 13 sums. We have done already 10th one or 11th we have done. Complete first exercise of it. Okay?
Okay.
And Hania, you do from your textbook. That is first exercise, okay?
Okay, sir.
If you are having any doubts, children, just put in the Wise app. Okay? Don't forget to put that. If you do, then we'll just clarify accordingly. All right. You can leave now, children, all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Bye.